Right. My name is Michael Taylors, and I'm a Sami and belong to some of the Sami or associations in the World Heritage Laponia. I also the chairman of the Laponia World Heritage Board, and for a time I have also been site manager because we have just employed the first site manager ever since the 1st of September. But my subject belongs more to one of the morning sessions, as you can see in the program, so it doesn't exactly follow the subject of this. And if you want to read more about the Laponia, you can see this World Heritage magazine issued by UNESCO. There is a perfect article. I haven't found any fault in it. A description of a new spirit of consensus. And thank you very much for the invitation, and I hope that I can give something back to you, because this is within the atmosphere of the World Heritage Convention, to work with information, with mutual learning processes and so on. And I think of your World Heritage Year, we have very much in common the transhumans, we have the conservation of nature, the cultural biodiversity questions, together with the local development, the possibility to develop the area. And we are also facing questions of kultur, materiell, immateriell. But from our side, when we started to build up a new management, a new organization for the Laponian site, we looked upon it as a repair process. We repaired the history. This is a very quick version of history covering more than 1,000 years. We have been hunting, fishing since 600 to 800 years ago. We started with the reindeer husbandry. We have also met colonization, exploitation, and confiscation of rights, of course, from the society of the majority. We got the appointment in 96, and maybe we have started since then a decolonization process. That's how we, from the Sami side, look upon this appointment from UNESCO. And from the 1st of January next year, we start in real terms the new management and organization to work with the World Heritage Site. Laponia is mixed World Heritage, nature and culture. It is located in the northernmost Sweden, close to the Arctic Circle. It is the largest protected area in Europe and contains 4 national parks and 3 huge nature reserves. The area is 9,400 square kilometers, larger than some member states of the European Union. It was inscribed in the list. It doesn't matter really. Inscribed in 1996 after several attempts made by the Swedish government. The application to UNESCO was approved first when the Sami people and our reindeer herding culture was included in the documents. It is also appointed as a diploma area given by the Conseil d'Europe. There are two designated Ramsar wetland areas within the site borders, one of them the biggest in Europe, and so on and so forth. And we have 65,000 reindeer in the area, counted on the winter herd. Despite the impression of this area as a wilderness, its tangible and intangible cultural values, which are extraordinary, and the earliest known traces of occupation date back to year 7000 before Christ, and it has, of course, since a long time ago been inhabited by us, the Sami peoples, and according to the UNESCO motivation, it is one of the last, largest, and best preserved examples of an area of transhumance, which shows steps of human, economic, and social development. And if you wonder, there are no Swedes living in the area. So we are there, going to stay there and work there and protect and develop the balance between men and nature. It means to keep on demonstrating a long-term sustainable land use while continuing with our traditional reindeer breeding or reindeer husbandry. It means we are migrating, following the seasons around the area and also outside the area in the forest land. And we occupy for our own 65,000 reindeer areas between the Atlantic and the Baltic Sea. Long distance for some of the Sami groups. And I will also stress that the reindeer herding is a certain basis for our culture, including the language. So, for us it is, and then I mean also the other parties that are involved in the new management, it is to protect, conservate, and take care, but also use the area and to develop it. We started... the so-called process of Laponia in 1999, arguing, discussions, fightings, negotiations. And the other parties are the following. Two local communities with together about 25 or 26,000 inhabitants. The government with its Swedish Protection Environmental Agency, the Swedish IPA, and also the County Administration Board. We failed with the discussion and restarted in year 2005, a new round. And in year 2006, we made a robust deal on how to continue the discussions. We also agreed upon to handle both the easy and the difficult questions at the same time, not starting with the easy questions. This package of document also presented what each party wanted to get out of it all, wanted to achieve, so to speak. And we sent this agreement to the Swedish government and asked for permission to find a solution of the management with some kind of heavy local involvement. We also asked for money for the coming next 3 years to support this new fired process. And the answer was yes from the government. They said, go on. And we also got the money. And for that reason, we created 5 different working groups with a lot of subjects to handle. We also discussed philosophical questions on the agenda, such as what is nature, what is culture, what is the role of the man in all this. And we have found, and that is also a basis for how we are going to work, how we are going to handle all the different types of landscape, for instance, the landscape inside our heads, the manscape, the social landscape, and so on and so forth. And this is important, and to find the balance between nature, the man, the landscape, and the use of the nature resources. From the Sami side, we brought up in the discussion a lot of international instruments that Sweden had signed. We found that the World Heritage Convention, with its operational guidelines, didn't give very much support as wished. We concentrated on the set of human rights convention, the set of environmental conventions, Agenda 21, Rio declarations, and the declarations of rights of indigenous peoples, and some UNESCO declarations, and some Council of Europe conventions. For instance, about minority language, how to handle that question in this case, cultural diversity and so on, the intangible heritage. Our thought was that all the beautiful ambitions and words in the documents have to land somewhere, even at the spot along the Arctic Circle. The Convention on Biological Diversity has, as you know, useful material, for instance, 8J, traditional knowledge in the in situ conservation, access and benefit sharing questions, the ethical code of conduct, the guidelines about sacred places. And we also lifted questions, which I have seen in the material about the theme here, questions about the unwritten law. It means customary law and habits and values. The result of all this is a new management plan. And for an example, the language is an area to take care of. So we included also the cultural values in the management plan. And instead of nature, we have nature descriptions in this, of course. But we have also portraits of inhabitants, of tourists in the area, and hunters, and so on. Just to handle the question, the man and the nature. We replaced old roles since 1909. Which we, in many cases, didn't understand in Swedish, what does it mean? They were sold for the national parks. Now we think they are modern, they are adapted to the reindeer herding demands and so on. And we got this new local management with its own charter. And that charter is also rather unique. And we got the Laponia Act for this management decided by the Swedish government. This is the legal instrument for government agencies to move over duties to the new organization. And what happens just now. Quite now, we are practically and physically establishing this local management, which is a joint, non-profit, locally based association. And it means that we take over from the national agencies all public services and run all the practical things like security for more than 60 bridges in the area and so on and so forth, and everything with full responsibility and with absolutely higher ambitions compared with those of the Swedish government. And as I mentioned in the beginning, from the 1st of September this month, last month, we just employed the first site manager ever. Now we are recruiting park rangers and other culture workers and so on. Some tool for this. We are working with it as a learning area, this, if we have a Sami word for it, a learning process. And in this case, and this is not so new thing, we have it in the principle of ecosystem within the Convention on Biological Diversity, an adaptive management. We have also part obligatory participatory mechanisms where we invite the local public. I mean, there are others than the Sami people involved in this, of course. And maybe the most important thing, the consensus technique for decision making. We have found during 12 years discussions now that it is a much stronger tool than majority and minority decisions. We earn the decision, all parties, when we work with it. And this work is here, in here. Listen to each other and all that, and so on. Accept other opinions, and be ready to change oneself. This is the board. The majority consists of local representatives. There are 5 Samis, 2 from the local communities and 2 from the Swedish government agencies, the county administrative board and this Swedish Environmental Protection Agency. And we have not solved all questions and concerns. We have created a platform which consists of many parts and in main based on Sami values, but it's also based on recognition of traditional knowledge for in situ conservation. But the real challenge starts now. How to burst current patterns of behavior and how to confront traditional knowledge with modernity. And are there some minutes? Yes. Yes, I was choosing. Tools and learnings of very big importance is to work with a statement of universal, outstanding universal values that all understand this concept. What does it mean? And also a basis for the new management and during the process until now have been the criterias from UNESCO. This is the main objective to protect, but also to develop. It's time to reach consensus. We must accept local knowledge. And the local knowledge, not only from the Sami side, also from other local inhabitants, it is a necessity. And another trick which was very useful, that was to adopt a common basis of values. 5 sentences, this is the basis for the work together. And also another thing, that is to treat each other as equals. The ordinary man in the 2 local communities, Gällivare and Jokkmokk, they are not equal with the bureaucrats and such people, but we must be treat each other in equal manner. That's absolutely necessary. The local community and the Sami or associations got many to hire daytime worker. They can't work at the kitchen table after a day out in the forest or out in the mountain and participate on equal terms with civil servants. We also adopted a technique which we will continue with, that is horizontal criteria which are used within the European Union. We have asked, is this a good decision? And then we have judged it against, is it good for nature? Is it good for nature? And so on. Is it good for disabled persons? So there is a set of horizontal criteria to judge ideas and to just, can we improve it? Can we accept this is not good for the culture and go on? And another thing is to govern through guidelines. We are not going to work with authority exercises. We are not going to have that level in our work. But we are going to help the decision-making authorities created guidelines. Example for tourism. We have set out the principles for it in here, and then it's an help for the authority when judging things like mining questions and forestry. We don't have it inside the site, but just outside it. We don't have any buffer zone. This concept, buffer zone, doesn't exist in the Swedish legislation, but we have created our temporary buffer zone. And there we have created also guidelines for the authorities when they are working with concession question for mining activities and so on. I hope during the days to give you better and more examples, learnings and tools for this type of a new management. This was just to give a glimpse of what's going on up there. I was there some days ago. The winter has already come. I have seen the first snow. And today I prolonged my summer.